long time ago when the earth was green, and there was more kinds of animals than you'd ever seen. They'd run around free while the earth was being born, but the loveliest of them all was the unicorn.
Well, this is productive work. You know what, Ingo? This would be the perfect time for 5 minutes with Ingo.
Okay, sure. So we have a puzzle here. Let's think about this. Graeme, quick task for you.
Okay.
I would like to ask you, describe a puzzle, the concept of a puzzle to me, but without using actually the word puzzle. Can you do that?
Let's see. Yeah, 200 pieces.
Ooh, yeah.
Okay, that's, well, yeah, fair enough. That's a good idea. So you say something with 200 pieces, that's a puzzle. All right. Okay, have a look at this here. That here is a bowl with sugar bags.
Yeah.
And those have to be also like 200 bags. So I say those are 200 pieces, so therefore that's a puzzle, right?
I'm going to have to go ahead and sort of disagree with you there.
But you just said something with 200 pieces is a puzzle.
Right, but that's not. But I know that's not a puzzle.
Okay, well, you have a point. You as a human being can say that, but imagine how difficult it actually is for a machine or for an algorithm to figure this one out. Let's have a look. Okay, so we have a couple of data points here. We have seen this last episode already, that we can put data points into this two-dimensional space.
Yes.
So actually, I would like to explain those data points, finding a function which is explain those data points, for example, by touching them, and so that you can use the function and in order to predict what is the value, for example, somewhere here. Graeme, another task for you. Can you, while I open this up for you,
okay,
can
thanks.
You actually paint such a function, such a line explaining those data points?
You mean like connect them?
Well, yeah, for example, yeah.
Okay, all right, let's see here.
That looks pretty nice.
Yeah, okay. That looks great.
It's great. So this is one way how you could do this. And I think that's probably something many people would come up with. But so maybe we can come up with something else. So I, for example, could go with this function here. I could go up here, a little bit around, and down again.
Oof.
Yeah.
That's...
Yeah, that's complex.
Yeah.
I know.
Non-linear, you might say.
Yeah, it's probably not really linear. So, what are you thinking about this one?
I think it's messy.
Yeah, messy is a good description, really. It's, you look at this and you really think like, well, the green function here, that's good enough. So why are you making things more complex? Why are you making things more difficult? Because it's not really necessary. It's just like you're adding complexity to this whole function without any reason.
Yeah.
That's something people usually wouldn't do.
Yeah.
You usually try to make things as simple and easy as possible. All right, so then I have another idea here. So, thank you. So, I could now say, maybe we can come up with something which is even simpler. Can you come a little bit closer, please? Yeah, thank you. So let's go with this one here. Look at that. That one is even simpler. It comes as at a price though, because now we are no longer touching all the black dots here. So we are not explaining every data point exactly, but we're pretty close for all data points. And the function is even easier because it's just linear. That would be, by the way, the outcome of a linear regression model. And we talked about regression like a couple of episodes ago, which is a little bit different than those classification tasks. So anyway, so now we have this regression line. It's very, very simple, but it comes at a price that you're no longer correct for those data points. Okay, we got that. But I still think it's a great idea. Why? Because in all those cases, like have a look at, for example, here, at around this area here, if I would ask, well, here's a new point, and I would like to know what is the value of this point.
That would be great.
The red function would say, well, it's about this value. The green one is pretty close as well, maybe a good idea. But look at the blue one. That's totally off. So that's not really great. And the reason for that is just because it's too complex and you come up with solutions which are not very likely. So let's talk about the puzzle for a second again. So you came up with the idea saying a puzzle is consisting of 200 pieces, yeah. which is too complex. And that leads to wrong decisions for other objects. Not a good idea. And we call this overfitting. And that's a very important concept of machine learning. What you just did, you have been creating overfitting. Your model was too complex, too complicated for describing a puzzle. In the same sense that this line here is too complex to describe those data points. So it's very important to control overfitting, because otherwise your predictions are going to be really, really bad. Okay, that's from me on overfitting today.
And this has been your 5 minutes with Ingo.
There was green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty macaws and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, the loveliest of all was the unicorn.
Okay, so if you can solve this challenge, you can win an amazing prize. Data scientist number 7, show the prize. Beautiful. This puzzle here of a nice unicorn, autographed and signed by data scientist number 7 and me personally. Okay, you have to answer the following question. Which of those two modeling techniques, linear regression and k-nearest neighbors, is more vulnerable against outliers? Think about this and tweet the result at Ingo Mierswa. Thanks.
You're never going to see no unicorn.
Yeah, well, I'm just not sure about that right now.